Within the last decade, this beauty from Cebu has made a name for herself as a brilliant and dedicated designer. Now she's dressed some of the country's most gorgeous stars and society's elite. Whether it be walking down red carpet or down the church aisle, she makes sure every woman feels her most beautiful best. So let's welcome renowned couturier and purveyor of timeless design. Our next woman of style is Vania Romoff. Hey girl, what's up? Finally, you're on Women of Style. What's new? What's happening with you, girl?
Well, today, we cleared it just for you.
Thank you.
But I mean, on a normal day, you know, I see clients. This is our main headquarters, so it's where I see a lot of women, actually, who come in and have their bespoke gowns made.
How does the process start for that when you have a client?
Well, normally, of course, it starts with an appointment.
Sometimes I ask them, is there something that you resonate with or that you love about our designs? Mm-hmm. And for the most part, some women pick up their phones and they go through our website or our Instagram. I love this gown. And then from there, I can sort of pick up what kind of style they're really at.
Say it's something that's a bit frilly or extremely feminine, and then I pick up from there, getting all those details within like 10 minutes and just putting it all on a sketch. I make one or two, give them a choice, three sometimes, and then show them swatches. I would say it's really a collaboration.
But curiosity, Vania personally.
No one's ever asked me that.
No, you personally, what is Vania's personal style?
I like to be relaxed. I mean, when I go to work at least, I love to wear something that shows my personality, which is, for the most part, just really chill. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, now, I guess, a sweater, but then, like, a skirt. So it's always that balance between not being, like, too saccharine and, like, too feminine, but I like to pair it down with like I like to wear jeans, and but I'll pair it with a blouse and a bow, and so it's just really, I think, practical. I'm a very practical woman.
Did this happen that as time went on for you, or have you always been like this even when you were a teenager?
I think like any teenager, I think my style was like a bit flip-flop. I was still trying to discover, you know, what I really wanted. But now, obviously now that I'm a mom as well, I mean, that hasn't really changed much, but I guess I would say I've become more confident in what I know looks good on me. The same way I feel more confident in what I know looks good on other women.
When you were growing up, the bevy of women in your life, were you already attracted to certain cuts and styles?
Of course. I think, and that's sort of what triggered, I think, my aesthetic, is that because I grew up surrounded by designers. Early on, my grandmother, I would have custom dresses at birthday parties. And, you know, I also grew up working behind the scenes for my brother. And so that's influenced me greatly as well. I wasn't a designer then, but I would see fittings. And I could already sort of appreciate certain cuts and designs. And I already had favorite fabrics. So even before I, you know, decided that I wanted to be a designer, I had a very strong, I think, point of view already. That's why I think I started out with creating evening gowns, because that's what I loved.
Well, that's fun.
It is.
It's fun to be you.
It is. And I meet so many, so many amazing women. You know, meeting those women, it really inspires me.
What kind of woman is a Vania woman?
Oh, I would think a Vania woman is someone who is really confident in their style. Confident enough to want to wear something that is a bit more refined and pulled back. Not necessarily, I think, ostentatious. So you'll see a lot of our designs are a bit more classic, but, you know, romantic still in a modern way.
Do you see that your little one also like following suit? Does she also like pull on like some gowns?
I mean, it's funny that you ask that, because you know she is going through a princess phase. She's three, and so I introduced her to Disney princesses, and when she realized that her mom was making, she would ask me, "Mom, what do you do?" I said, "I'm going to work." She's like, "Again?" And I'm like, "Yeah." She's like, "What do you do at work?" And I said, "Well, I make turnaround dresses," because she calls big dresses turnaround dresses. And she said, "Mom, can you make me a turnaround dress too? Can you make me something like Belle or Cinderella?" And and I make her dresses.
This is so much fun.
Yes.
Mom can provide me the that experience of a turnaround dress to be like her favorite cartoon
character. Yes, and so she sees clients stand on the podium in front of the mirror and she does the same thing. She'll go on there and then she'll turn around. And so I feel like it's very much a little bit of deja vu.
Yeah.
Because it's what I experienced as well when I was younger.
Is it true? I heard that there's a rumor you have like a new collection.
Yes, we do. Actually, I'd love for you to try a few pieces. I think it could be fun. What do you think?
I would love to try them, girl.
So let's do it.
When we return, Vania takes us into the art of haute couture and shares why making women feel more beautiful is a passionate pursuit that will never go out of style.
I think our clientele, or the Filipina in general, have become more confident and more, I think, open.
Hi!
Hello there, Miss Amelia.
This is Amelia. This one is by another photographer, Ralph Mendoza, who I work with. This is the rest of our humble home.
Very spacious.
Vania, you have a very beautiful home.
Thank you.
Very comfortable. And thanks for showing me some of your art pieces.
Thank you.
But just to have more detail of the art pieces, the story with the pieces you showed me, which were your husband's favorite.
Choices,
Yes. So do you have the photo of some beach? Oh, no, it's like it's a beach somewhere with the bunker.
Yes, yeah. I mean, you know, we love being at the beach. We love sort of going out of town. And he's from Switzerland, so he loves the lake. So it's just living in the city and just sort of missing out the outdoors, which is why we have a lot of plants in our home, almost a little jungle. I don't know how many plants we have, but my husband loves them. So we try and bring a little bit of that outdoor vibe into the home.
So it's a fusion. Your home is a fusion of your husband and you?
Yes. It is.
What are the Vania aspects of your home?
The flowers. I try to bring in as much flowers as I can. I love arranging them myself. I've arranged these flowers myself. We go to the flower market and do it whenever I have the time.
Flower market as in Dangwa flower?
Yes,
no way!
Yes!
What time in the morning are you getting up to
early,
go to Dangwa?
Around after her school. A lot of the books are mine and some are hers as well, so she loves reading books. This is not our property per se, we're renting, but we try to make it feel like our home as much as we can.
Your husband also has work in the metro?
My husband and I work together.
Oh, I did not know this.
Well, the company was always there, but we helped expand it together. When we got married, we did Rockwell. And then, of course, he's also a hockey player. He is the captain of the national ice hockey team.
That's amazing.
Yeah, so he used to play in Switzerland, and then when he moved here, I actually just typed on Facebook hockey, found out there was a hockey league, and fast forward, they won gold in the SEA Games. They're going to play again in November. So, and then he helps me. So both of that, like a good balance. So there goes my daughter. She just skipped out.
Yeah.
she has had it with our conversation. She has better things to do.
She has a different agenda.
Yes,
she's got to read Frozen. Okay.
Yes, that's true.
But I'm really fascinated about your background, Vania. Mm-hmm. I'd love to know, what is your DNA? What is your mixing pot?
I'm from Cebu. My mother is half Spanish, half Ilongga. And my father is half Russian, half Filipino.
It's amazing.
Yes.
What a beautiful mix. And your husband is?
My husband is Swiss-Filipino.
Swiss-Filipino.
Swiss-Ilonggo. We speak Ilonggo, Cebuano, and Tagalog in the house, and a little bit of Swiss. So it gets mixed up.
I love it. Global citizens. And Amelia is like an international child of the world. And then with your travels, do you also have a chance to visit, family in Europe?
Yes, so we alternate holidays.
every other year we go to Switzerland. It gets really cold there,
yes,
but I love it.
I'm thinking when I think Switzerland that most of the time it's a colder climate.
Yeah, and especially when we go there during the holidays. So I love it in the summer because it's great. I mean, nice weather, swimming in the lake. For the holidays, you know, traditional winter in the Alps kind of fondue
hot
season.
Chocolate.
Yes, yeah. It's a different experience and I love it.
That's a wonderful little mix. And if I was little Amelia, the world is so huge because my parents and my grandparents.
Yeah.
Vania, your roles at home as being a partner, being a mom.
Yeah.
But for Vania, what are the elements that you do for your own you time, your self-care?
My time. As much as possible, I love to sort of leave Manila, as one does when you kind of have too much of it.
Yeah.
I love to go on mini vacations. I love to just sometimes just read a book. Netflix is one of my guilty pleasures as well. You know, just spending time with my daughter sort of just puts me in a world that is different from the world that I work in. And that just gives me that balance because the fashion world in itself is hectic and crazy sometimes.
Crazy, fun,
yes,
stressful. I love
everything.
It.
And so it's nice that I find that I have like, I wouldn't say two lives, but it's just, it's very different. The Vania that you see in the studio versus the Vania that you will see at home, I feel is very different because in the studio, I'm a go-getter. I sort of have, I have this whole team under me, so I'm really there just like just going from one topic to the next. And then when I get home, I just kick back, lay on this couch that sort of cuddles me in and just forget about everything and just focus on my family and just being chill.
When we return, we delve into Vania's continuing journey in design and how it feels to be marking a decade in the business.
If you're passionate about something enough to really go against all the odds and just go for it.
Like from your studio in Makati and then now reaching out to Ready to Wear to Rockwell.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I understand that your team have developed an app.
So we call it Personal Shopper. And what happens is if you find something nice on our stories, for example, say the top you wore a while ago, all you need to do is swipe up and it directly goes to your WhatsApp where you get connected with our girls in the store who can help you and show you the items that you like and show you pieces that could match it perhaps. And so it becomes a very personal shopping experience as opposed to something that's very just technical, type in your credit card numbers and all of that.
Yes, so you still have that essence of what you enjoy
exactly,
as a designer.
Exactly.
And also the customer also now has more free flow.
Exactly,
with pieces. Of course you guys are expanding, but what is expansion for you? I'm thinking international.
Yes, that's always, of course. I mean, that's always been, you know, a goal of mine to sort of reach an international client base. And I've always thought that, you know, I'm going to get there. And that's what is really inspiring me because I know there's so much more room to grow. And so over the years, the main goal is really to have a ready-to-wear store. So we have that now. The brand is Filipino-made. It always has been. So I wanted to keep it that way. But of course, financially, it wasn't in the books for us to be able to expand right away. And hopefully next year, by slowly expanding our production base, which is why we're moving to a new studio soon. And then once that happens, we get the ball rolling and hopefully, you know, this little Filipino brand goes overseas. So we'll see.
The goal there, envision it. I see you along Rodeo Drive.
Oh my goodness, that's a far
Fifth
cry.
Fifth Avenue. Right?
Yeah.
A lot of my designs always echo a sense of femininity, sensuality, and always remains classic.
It's been a year you have mm-hmm. been honored by Metro. Yes. You're part of the Metro family yes. and part of icons.
I know, I
As
know.
As a designer, like, wow, how would that feel?
You know, a year ago, it was really overwhelming. It still is now, every time I think about it. More because I was the youngest Metro Art designer, and all the designers before me, I looked up to. You know, I remember attending a Carrie Santiago Metroware Icon Show. And then years, and never in my entire life did I think that I would be, you know, on that very stage. I feel it just goes to show that, you know, if you work hard enough and if you really want something, it doesn't matter if it takes you 10 years to get there, yeah. you know, you'll get there. And it's you know, the feeling is even sweeter because the feeling of being able to attain something that wasn't done overnight feels so surreal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very rewarding.
Exactly.
I, the scene in my, I was it your daughter that came up with flowers for you? I remember seeing that in some of the Instagram yes. stories.
Yeah, she was very attentive throughout the whole show. I've seen a lot of videos of that. And yes, I think, you know, I never thought that I would be walking down that Metro Art Icon stage and having my daughter give me the flowers. And it's just, I could never have hoped for like a better sort of moment.
Well, for beautiful all of that. Things for a beautiful soul. I'm excited for what more Vania will be producing, what I'll see in your mm-hmm. transitions. 10 years. Another 10, 15 years.
Oh my goodness, that's a long time right? from now. But you know, one can dream.
Yeah, and your dream is already in fruition. When it comes to like younger designers,
yeah.
when they ask you for advice, what do you share with them?
If you're passionate about something enough to really, you know, go against all the odds and just go for it, that anything is possible. You know, I really think that, you know, that saying is true, every word of it. Which is why I'm saying this right now, and I'm hoping that in 10, 15 years' time, I'm going to look back at this interview and think, you know, I said that.
Yes, and I still live it, and I'm still in agreeance to it. Vania, we have the same question mm-hmm. I get to all of my wonderful guests on the show, mm-hmm. asking them about women of style
yeah.
and your own opinion.
Mm-hmm.
You have grown up with such amazing women. You have yeah. wonderful clientele. Mm-hmm. What is a woman of style for you?
For me, a woman of style is someone of substance. I feel that if a woman has a certain character, that it shows in her sense of style. I think that how you feel inside sort of radiates. When you feel good about yourself, when you're confident about what you're doing in your life, you just have that extra, you know, step in your walk. And I think a woman of style sort of is a woman of now, of the world. I mean, every woman, I think.
Vania is without a doubt one of today's most exciting designers. With her youthful vision, her elegant aesthetics is the quintessence to the modern Filipina. And just like her couture creations, she is strong in spirit and confident in her femininity, hence the romance in every design. And with her touch, she creates magic and mystery, and that makes Vania Romoff a woman of style.
Okay, a few little okay. questions.
All right. So, you know when you like have icon dresses?
Icon dresses.
Or like from movies or mm-hmm. like when yes. like actors go yeah. on red carpet. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Like, can you like name a few and that are favorites like, through your time watching maybe red carpet?
I follow Kate Blanchett and Julianne Moore on the red carpet.
Kate
I mean,
Blanchett just
those
every
women
time.
Can do no wrong.
Super.
You know, they're always in Armani or Givenchy or, you know, a beautiful Valentino couture. I mean, I love that. For the younger generation, I do love, I think, Elle Fanning at Cannes.
Right.
Brilliant styling. Amazing.
Yes.
Thank you exactly. so much. Wait, let's do a selfie.
For saying.
Thank you.
You're
Vania.
Good. Thank you, Joey.
It was for my
so,
gift.
It was so easy.
When it comes to designing for women, Vania has only one goal in mind, to elevate femininity into effortless fashion. That's why every woman feels more confident donning a Vania Romoff piece.
Wearing the new collection of Vania. I love it!
Do you?
I feel like a flower that's bloomed.
This is part of our ready-to-wear collection this season. It's pre-holiday. It comes in white and blue and, of course, lilac, which is really playful, which is why I wanted you to wear it.
I do love the lilac.
Right? Lilac moment. And so this is our hero piece, as we call it, for this season. So it's what carried the entire collection, and we worked around this top and then sort of just made a collection around it.
I feel like it makes you look sort of like a sculpture. It highlights the woman's silhouette like an hourglass almost. And so this is actually just regular silk, and we had it pleated, iron pleated, and then we added the nice sort of bow there, and just sort of completes the look.
It's a top and a skirt, actually, so you could easily sort of pair it off with something really casual, like a denim pant.
Denim pants, like blush slacks.
You could. And so we sell it as two pieces. If you want to wear it to a nice wedding, you can also put it on together, and it becomes like a whole dress almost.
And I feel like with the modern fashionista now, that's what they want, more bang for the buck.
Exactly.
And you recycle and also
sustainability.
Yes. Exactly.
I love it. Add this to the Joy Meet account.
Yes,
for this
please.
Top.
You look amazing
top.
In
Thank
it.
You.
Yeah.
What do you think is this generation of a modern Filipina compared to maybe like two decades ago? Do you see her adjustments and her shifts?
I think so. I think our clientele, or the Filipina in general, have become more confident and more, I think, open to, you know, different kinds of styles and silhouettes, because everything is just digital now. Mm-hmm. Everybody sees everything, and so, you know, there's so much ideas, there's so much styles to sort of just take in. And you can see it. It's a reflection when you walk into a party. You'll see women wear the most bold and amazing looks.
The bridal world.
Yes.
It's a different beast.
It is.
But this is how you started, yes?
I did it in my earlier years, so around 2000 and...
2000-something.
Yeah, with Kim Jones, First Bride. Yes.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah. It worked out for me. Like, I started bridal, would have maybe one bride in 2 months. It was really slow. And then it picked up. And then I realized that I actually really loved it. I feel like it's such an important sort of experience, because the one between you and a bride is very personal. It's a whole other level of creating something. It's special. So, and I love that feeling of a bride standing in front of me and just feeling really good about her dream dress. When I started bridal, I really knew, you know, the kind of bride I wanted to dress up. And we were very much all about just the simple, clean lines. I love good beadwork as much as the next person, but I found that my strength was really in creating just clean silhouettes and simple, classic pieces. And so we found our niche of brides, and we've been doing it ever since, and we've come up with ready-to-wear bridal, which is really picked up. A lot of the brides I feel in the Philippines, or, you know, anywhere, for example, love to try on a gown and really see how it fits before committing to it.
Has there been times when you have created for the bride-to-be, mom of bride, mom of groom, and even to when it comes down to the flower girls, like the whole shabam? That's like a
yes,
lot of
that's
work.
That's a lot of work. That is. I know that personally because I also did that for my own wedding. I ended up creating my own gown and creating for my mom, my mother-in-law, my daughter, my entourage, and all the guests. Because of course the guest is like, no, we want to wear you. We're not going to wear another brand or designer because it's your wedding.
I am so fascinated listening to your stories, bridal, the people who you work with, mm-hmm. you're ready to wear. But now it's time to bring us home to your humble abode.
Stay tuned. After the break, Vania brings us to her new abode and shares with us her bigger dreams for her growing brand.